Students, now let us study about the characteristic of a phylum Annelida. First characteristic, body of this animal is long, cylindrical and metamorphically segmented. Second, most of the animals are free living but few are ectoparasites. Free living animals may be marine or freshwater travelers or terrestrial. Third characteristic, these animals are triploblastic, bilateral, symmetrical and eucoelomate. Fourth characteristic, they have setae or parapodia or suckers for locomotion. Fifth, their body is covered with a special cuticle. Sixth, these animals are either hermaphrodites or unisexual. Example are earthworm, leech, neris, etc. Here even the diagrams are being shown of the animal. Now let us move on to the next phylum, that is Arthropoda. First characteristic, these animals have jointed appendages, hence they are called as Arthropodas. Second, planet Earth has highest number of animals from this phylum. Hence, this is the largest phylum with a higher successful animal in the animal kingdom. Third, these animals are found in all type of habitat ranging from deepest ocean to highest mountains. Fourth, body of this animal is triploblastic, eucoelomate, bilateral, symmetrical and segmented. Fifth characteristic, chitinous exoskeleton is present around their body. Sixth, these animals are unisexual. Example of these animals are crab, spider, scorpion, millipede, centipede, cockroach, butterfly, honeybee, etc. Now, here they have told us one characteristic, that these animals are found in any type of habitat from deepest ocean to highest mountain. That I want to discuss with you. See, if you have seen that cockroach, if it goes in our refrigerator, it can survive in that cold also. Means these animals have a habitat to stay in any condition, in any climate. So they have told us that these animals are found from deepest ocean to the highest mountains. So all these characteristics I am going to explain you again in Marathi. Thank you.